Hello and welcome to Thermochemical Equations and their application to energy mole mass conversions. The first thing we need to know about is the energy term and how it is used and placed in the equation. There are various pieces of information the energy term can give us, and we will go through four reactions to show the different ways the energy term expresses information, and then go through several conversion problems. The energy term tells us the energy change occurring in the reaction, and here it is placed on the product side for this reaction, the significance of which we will get to in a moment. But first we need to understand that the energy term can also be expressed apart from the reaction as its change in enthalpy, delta H, which is called the heat of reaction. We see that this is a negative heat of reaction, which has the same meaning as placing the energy term in the equation on the product side, both of which tell us that this is an exothermic reaction. An exothermic process occurs when energy is released or lost during a chemical or physical change. By placing the energy term on the product side, or by showing it as a negative heat of reaction, that is expressing a release or loss of energy. In this reaction, the energy term is on the reactant side, which is a positive heat of reaction. Both of these show an endothermic reaction, which is when energy is absorbed or gained during a chemical or physical process. Here, the energy change is positive, it is endothermic. The energy term on the reactant side shows that the reaction is gaining energy, which is a positive energy change. Here we see the decomposition of water, but with two different heats of reaction. Here we can see the importance of knowing the states of reactants and products. For heat of reaction number one, the reactant, water, is in the liquid state, while for the heat of reaction number two, water is in the gaseous state. Why does that give us two different heats of reaction? Let's look at it from a graphical perspective to understand these different delta H's. Will the reactant, water, be placed differently on the energy axis depending on its state? You're right, the answer is yes. For the two lines representing the starting energy of water, can you predict which represents the liquid and which is the gas? Yes, you're right again, liquid water is at a lower temperature than gaseous water. Liquid water has to absorb energy in order to become a gas. What's interesting here is that the products for both end up at the same energy. So which reactant has to gain more energy to get to the products? Gaseous water requires less energy than liquid water to get to the same products, so knowing the states is an important part of understanding the energy change in any chemical or physical process. Let's look at something very interesting. Here is the decomposition of HGO, mercury 2 oxide, and its heat of reaction, positive 180 kilojoules. It is exothermic. There are many reactions which are reversible, where the products react to produce the reactants, and this is a reversible reaction. Mercury and oxygen can react to form mercury 2 oxide. But notice the heat of reaction. The magnitude is the same, 180 kilojoules, but now it is negative. It is exothermic. So the decomposition of mercury 2 oxide requires the addition of 180 kilojoules to decompose. While the synthesis of HGO releases 180 kilojoules. The process is the same, just going in the opposite direction, and so its energy change is the same, but also going in the opposite direction. The gain of 180 kilojoules versus the loss of 180 kilojoules. Importantly, this energy change is tied to the number of moles represented by the coefficient. Let's explore that very important concept further. So we need to account for the amount of substance which results in any specific amount of energy change. So the energy term, the heat of reaction, gives the energy change per amount of moles shown by each coefficient. Let's see what that means for each species in this reaction. So in this reaction, the combustion of methanol, CH4O, 1,450 kilojoules is released for every 2 moles of CH4 reacted. And 1,452 kilojoules is released for every 3 moles of oxygen reacted and for every 4 moles of water produced and every 2 moles of carbon dioxide produced. I hope that you can see this relationship between energy and moles gives us access to the conversions between energy and moles and mass in the equation. Let's use those relationships to solve some conversion problems. What amount of energy is produced in the combustion of 100 moles of CH4O? The first statement gives us the relationship between the energy term and the amount of CH4O reacted. Okay, so let's start with the amount given in the problem, 100 moles of CH4O. And then we're going to multiply it by the relationship of the energy term and the coefficient, putting the unit we have on the bottom and the unit wanted on top. And here we have the relationship between the two units, 1,452 kilojoules for every 2 moles. So the reaction of 100 moles of CH4O gives us 72,600 kilojoules of energy released. The next question gives us grams instead of moles, but we still only have the relationship of kilojoules to moles, not grams. So we have to first convert grams of CH4O to moles. So we multiply by 1 mole over the molar mass. And that gets us moles of CH4O. We now can multiply by the relationship of moles to energy, and that is still 1,452 kilojoules for every 2 moles, which gives us 2,270 kilojoules released for every 100 grams of CH4O reacted. Okay, in the next problem, we're given kilojoules and asked for how many moles of CH4O must react to produce that amount, 100 kilojoules. So here we multiply it by the relationship of kilojoules on the bottom and moles on top. So for every 2 moles, we still have that same relationship, 1,452 kilojoules. And so the combustion of 0.14 moles of CH4O produces 100 kilojoules. Heats of reaction, however, are often expressed per mole for a specific substance. So let's see how that works. Here we're back to the synthesis of HGO. But the question is, what is the heat of reaction per mole of the decomposition of mercury to oxide, HGO? We have the synthesis of HGO given to us. So there's two things to consider. The fact that the equation gives us the heat of reaction for the synthesis of mercury to oxide, not its decomposition. And two, the energy term gives us the energy released for the synthesis of 2 moles of HGO. So we need to reverse the given reaction to get the decomposition reaction. And that will give us the correct sign for the heat of reaction, which is a positive 180 kilojoules. However, that energy term is for 2 moles of HGO. And so we divide 180 kilojoules by 2 moles, and that gives us the heat of reaction per mole, 90 kilojoules per mole. Okay, this has been a Mad Scientist production. See ya.